Yom Tov. Over the past year, the question I most frequently hear is, how are you surviving as president? The inquiry from friends and fellow congregants is not a surprise. After all, how does being president of a synagogue transform your life? Is it a never-ending series of issues, problems, and complaints sprinkled with enough positive feedback to make it worth the effort? Or does the grind of responsibility, endless attention to detail, and the inevitability that you will fail in some respects result in the tight-lipped answer, only 700 more days to go, knowing that it was 731 just yesterday and will be only 729 more tomorrow? How am I surviving? Today may be the time to answer that question. But before I do, I would first like to share with you what I learned during my first year as Herjick's president. I learned James Reynolds and those who maintain our facilities, Fatima Derrick, Joseph Hill, and Nefa Lane, are the unsung heroes in our building. In addition to doing, setting up, cleaning, fixing, sterilizing, and constructing anything and everything to make Herjick operate at peak efficiency, they do so with smiles and congeniality every day. I learned our early childhood education teachers are unparalleled in what they do. In the face of ever-changing pandemic conditions, they impart the highest ideals to our preschool students and do so with unqualified love as if they were caring for their own children. I learned our religious school educators are up to any challenge placed before them. In transforming the educational world in which their students learn, they teach about rituals, holidays, and values in fresh and exciting ways to create meaningful connections between their students and Judaism. I learned our office staff, Jeanette Quinones, Betsy Cass, and our new executive director, Lisa Stein, are superwomen of the highest caliber. In addition to wearing a multitude of hats to administer, initiate, support, and execute our operational needs, they show a respect and feeling for congregants that make them part of the familial fabric of our membership. I learned Herjick has stellar professionals whose devotion and dynamic personalities help guide our lives. From Rabbi Schlesinger's rejuvenation of the feeling of community in our synagogue to Hazan Zakarin's innovative ways to make Herjick a welcoming place filled with music and song. From Cheryl Karp's tireless energy to raise the bar for our early childhood education programs, to Rebecca Osder's involvement as coordinator of our family engagement to create attachments between and among families at our synagogue. I learned the lay leaders at Herjick, our executive team of Stan Cohn, Audrey Polinsky, Stephen Kreit, David Koffler, Elaine Garver, Laura Underweiser, Harold Kislick, Rachel Cooper, Norman Doctor, and Liz Kislick. Those who chair or serve on committees, those who are the bedrock of Herjick's financial security, from Harry Castle patrons to the Wall of Windows participants, whose generosity led to the renovation of our ballroom, reception room, and Simcha patio spaces. Those who volunteer their time by attending Minyan, organizing sisterhood events, or getting their hands dirty in the mitzvah garden. And those members and preschool families who recently stepped forward to be future leaders at our synagogue. All of these people are the foundation of what makes Herjick strategically sound. I learned after adding 19 new families to Herjick's membership rolls last year that an additional 24 new families joined Herjick this year, including nearly a dozen families registering their children on our Building Blocks program, together with those in our neighborhood who hear the steady heartbeat of life that Herjick exudes in its ritual services, its adult education program, and its events for families. And that Herjick's growth bears witness to the vibrancy that exists in our synagogue through engagement and events. I learned we could collectively mourn the loss of congregants like Sandy Feit, whose devotion to our youth program serves as an example for others to follow, and whose passing this year left a hole in the heart of our synagogue, while we could also bestow our collective thanks to Barry Barotkin, an unassuming, devoted member at Herjick for decades, who stepped forward and donated the financial resources needed to complete our new state-of-the-art childhood playground that will bring joy and laughter to thousands of preschool children for decades to come. In sum, my education at Herjic this year was stupendous. I learned Herjic is filled with inspiring, dedicated people. I learned any accolades offered to me rightly belong to Herjic's staff and the multitude of volunteer congregants who dot the I's and cross the T's each and every day. And I learned with the talents of so many people here that Herjic stands as a dominant force of egalitarian conservative Judaism on the South Shore of Long Island. Over the last 12 months, many of you spoke with or wrote to me to express your recognition and appreciation for the changes we added to Herjic. You relayed your smiles seeing Facebook pictures of young children throwing whipped cream pies at Rabbi Schlesinger's face in the Haman-themed booth at our Purim carnival, or of learning with him in his monthly Talmud class. You expressed your pleasure seeing social media posts of Chazan Zakarin singing with s'more-eating students at the Lag BaOmer bonfire, or attending her series of Passover cooking classes. You extolled the warmth of joining 150 fellow members once every month at our Kabbalat Shabbat dinners, or being able to rely on Herjic during a particularly arduous time. You communicated your decision to participate in the synagogue event or lend your voice to the welcoming spirit we show to members, new members, preschool families, non-members, and guests alike. In all, you shared your feelings that Herjic is more than simply a synagogue. It is an expression of who we are as a community. A year ago, I stood before you and asked each of you to find 10 words to define your connection to Herjic. So many of you did that in untold ways. Today, I would like to urge you to treat this new year as an opportunity to join in our collective journey toward long-term stability. In that drive, there are two equally important components, one centered on engagement and one centered on financial support. With respect to engagement, I ask each of you to take time once a month to join in something Herjic is doing. Engagement need not alter the trajectory of your life. It only requires you to carve out a small piece in your heart where Herjic can flourish. Register for the Progressive Dinner. Attend a Kabbalat Shabbat service. Volunteer in the Mitzvah Garden. Come to a Minyan service to enable someone to say Kaddish. I promise you will not be disappointed in what you gain from your experience or what you will add to our community. With respect to financial support, I am pleased to announce the kickoff of the most ambitious fundraising effort in Herjic history, the Etz Chaim Endowment Campaign. To date, 8 of Herjic's top donors, families, have pledged a total of $550,000. When the Etz Chaim campaign is completed, Herjic aims to establish a $2 million permanent lifeline for our future that will continue to grow with time. Being part of this effort is not only for you, but for the generations to come, and will affirm your belief that Herjic's future is worth securing. It will reflect your desire for our spirit of community to be shared by members in the years to come. Participate at whatever level you believe will make the campaign a success. Participate to be counted among us. Participate to make a difference, not for today, but for tomorrow. When combined, engaging with and financially supporting Herjic will not only keep our central place on the map of conservative Judaism, but also make our community and our synagogue that much stronger. This is the challenge I am ready to take on. These are my 10 new words for the year. This is the challenge I am willing to take on. And I ask each of you to join me in embracing that challenge. Whenever I experience struggles in my life, my dad would remind me to pause and look back to see how far I'd figuratively climbed. From your words to me this past year, we seem to be on this journey together. Therefore, today, step back with me to see how far we've climbed. We learned a lot about HERJC. Hopefully, we accomplished a great deal as well. Progress motivates us to continue. So tomorrow we will move forward. Our efforts will begin in this new year of 5783. New goals will be set, help will be needed. In the end, I firmly believe progress will come to shine on our community. And as president, I owe my unending thanks to all those here today who helped to realize our dreams. So how am I surviving as president? I suppose my answer is this: 730 more days and 10 new words to go. I look forward to the tomorrows to come in our lives. May you and your families be written in the book of life for a sweet and healthy new year. And may Herjic be there to rejoice with you and for you to lean upon when needed throughout this year. L'shana tova.